morning, everybody. Welcome to day two of my Vlogmas. December the 2nd already. My name's Nicola, if you don't already know, and I'm sharing my Vlogmas videos with you every day in the run-up to Christmas, just a sort of short videos each day. And thank you all so much for the wonderful comments and likes on yesterday's first Vlogmas video. It was really good fun to see all the Vlogmases that are out there. It's my favourite time of year on YouTube because everybody's uploading such beautiful videos. I like to see all their advents and what they're getting up to. So thank you all for sharing yesterday with me. I've just made myself a really nice hot coffee, and I don't always froth the milk and put chocolate sprinkles on, but it's a bit chilly today and I fancied a little treat. So I've got it in my lovely eggnog penguin cup that I bought last year. I will actually share some of my Christmas cups with you on one of the videos. It's a little bit of a bone of contention in this house. I'm a bit obsessed with buying new mugs, and Justin doesn't really understand it, so I don't know if any of you have got similar experiences with your partners and husbands and so on, that they don't quite understand what all the fuss is about. But I like to have lots of different mugs for general and special Christmas cups and mugs. So on the 1st of December, I do a mug swap and put all the regular ones away and get all my Christmassy ones out. And I always add a couple more to my collection every year. So it's the little things, isn't it, that just make you happy and make your morning cup of coffee so much more enjoyable. I did have quite a few comments about my Christmas quilt here yesterday, so thank you for those. This is a quilt that I made this year, earlier this year. I think I started it in July. I sort of did a Christmas in July thing. And if you want to see a little bit more about it, I did do a quilting video. I'll pop a link down in the description box below, but you can find that quite simply. It's only about four or five videos back, might be about half a dozen now, but if you look back on my channel, you will find a quilting video and I share lots more information about that. Just got a spotty backing on it, but I share all the info there if you wanted to have a look at that, if you're interested. So also, you guys were quite, especially the all of you viewers that are in America, were, I'm sorry for the scares that I gave you all when I put footage of my drive to run a couple of errands yesterday. I appreciate that if you are used to driving on the wrong side of the road, that you would think it was a bit scary watching that video. But as you can see, it was absolutely fine. It's just completely different. It just blows your mind, doesn't it, when your brain is so used to seeing traffic flowing in one direction and suddenly it's all wrong. It's just a little bit disconcerting. But the countryside was lovely. We're very lucky to live where we live here on the east coast of England in Suffolk. So we're sort of within the countryside and yet just a few minutes literally from the coast. So I'll also try and get down there a couple of times during Vlogmas and share that scenery with you too. So I didn't actually film that. I was driving and concentrating and Justin was with me and he was doing the filming. So, but it's all good fun, isn't it? Okay, so I have got my advent to share with you this morning. I'm gonna open my stitchery advent, which is the one that lives in here. And the So Sweet Violet one will be tomorrow, so that will be every other day, but this one will be every day. So let me just have another sip of my coffee because it's too good to let get cold. Okay, let's have a look for number two. Here we go. Handily, not too far. And the light is perfect in here today for filming. I don't have to faff around and worry about where the shadows are. It was actually quite frosty overnight, I think. Got really, really cold, down to about 3 degrees Celsius when I looked this morning when I got up to make my first cup of coffee. Yeah, and no sign of the sun today. It's just really sort of cloudy, but at least it's dry. Okay, so let's open this up. And see what's inside. Something really pretty. That is a tiny beautiful little pin cushion or pin cape in a little vintage metal container. And as you can see, the fabric, it looks to me like it's probably vintage, or certainly sort of reproduction vintage. It's a little fleur-de-lis print, tiny, tiny. You can see how small that is. If I just pop it in my hand like that, that is adorable. So that's another beautiful advent gift from my Stitchery advent calendar. So I can pop that down. And I will, I'm keeping all those bits together so that at the end I can just do an array of all the goodies that I got from my calendars and share it all right at the end of Vlogmas. Well, yesterday I did get on in the afternoon with some stitching, and I'm very, very close to finishing these smalls. These are all from the Lori Holts Vintage Christmas sampler pattern. I'm doing them just individually. You can stitch them all as a whole sampler, and I did all the borders yesterday around these, all these ones, and I've just got to finish off. This is going to be Rudolph. You can see I've got some sparkly Ada, which I dyed myself, and I'm going to finish this one off today, and then later on I'm going to try and set the camera up in a way that I can show you some of the putting these together, finishing them as very small pillows. And I think these ones I'm going to finish so they can hang on my Christmas tree when that goes up, because I've got quite a few of these that are almost done that just need borders round, on another piece of cloth that I'm going to use as pillows, just to put in a little bowl with some sweeties at Christmas so they look cute. But these ones I thought would look nice on the Christmas tree, so I'll get those, I'll get that set up later on, and I'll share some of my finishing with you. Hopefully I can get it to be nice and clear so you can see what I'm doing. But I thought it'd be fun just to share that with you as part of today's video. So other than that, I'm going to sit now and finish my coffee. I might have a few cheeky stitches on Rudolph, and I'll pop back later on and show you some more of my day. I'm just going to start preparing these cross-stitch pieces that I showed you earlier for making into the little pillows to make as ornaments for my Christmas tree. Now, all the instructions that I'm using and the method that I'm using is all from a tutorial on Lori Holts' YouTube channel, which I will put a link to down below. And all you need to search for is the pillow tutorial, and you'll find it quite easily. So I've got my cross stitch pieces here, and obviously my rotary cutter and my ruler. I've also got a selection of Christmas fabrics here, which I'm going to choose some pretty ones. These are all just scraps from other projects that I've made. So I'm going to go through and find a pretty fabric for the backing of each pillow. And I've got a selection of some felt. These are just regular felt pieces that I've got. I think in Lori's video she does use felt with an adhesive backing, but I couldn't find that here, so I just use this and sew it on. And for the embellishments, I've got some of the Lori Holts. These are the tiny cute little buttons, just a quarter of an inch, because some of these designs here have little embellishments with the buttons, so I've got those here ready to pop on. And I've got a couple of ribbons to use for the hangers. I might use baker's twine, but I've just pulled these out as potentials. Okay, so the first thing that I need to do is cut these pieces with a 3/4 inch. So you need to do it 3/4 inch away from the design. So with the design edge being here, hopefully you can see that, it's nice and clear. And so you just need to cut. So I make my first cut to there, and then we'll get this piece cut off, and then we can be not worrying about the other ones on the cloth. Uh, Okay, so if I just pop that one to one side, so I'll just finish squaring up Santa. Make sure my ruler isn't slipping. I think it's the height of the actual stitches. So as you can see, the finished size of these is going to be really cute. I'll insert a picture of some of the summer ones that I made earlier in the year, so you get the idea of what we're aiming for. And I think we already trimmed that one. Yep, so we're good to go on that one. That one's a good size and ready. And I'll trim the other ones up later. But now I just need to go through some of my fabrics and see what might look cute on the back of this Santa one. And I think the red Christmas tree, some of these are from charm packs. This is actually from a charm pack that I used for the Christmas quilt that was on the back of my sofa earlier. So I think the red Christmas trees will go really nicely on the back of Santa. And I need to choose some felt to go with. And as a nice contrast on there, I think a piece of green felt will go nicely on the back. I've got my buttons ready. And I will go away now and sew the button onto the pom-pom of Santa's hat. And then I will come back at probably not today, but maybe tomorrow, and show you sewing these up, because I'll get these all cut out, the fabric's chosen, get the button sewn on, and then I'll show you possibly in tomorrow's video how that you then sew them all together and make them into the pillows. Well, it's much later in the day now. As you can see, it's got a bit dark. I think it's about 4 o'clock, and I had to pop out and do a few bits, get a few bits of grocery shopping, and just sat and spent some time finishing off, well, almost finished, really nearly finished, Rudolph. Just got to do a little bit more of the border, and you'll have seen the little video that I made cutting out the other little motifs ready to make them into the pillows. So this is nearly done, and I'll get the rest of that prepped to share with you probably tomorrow, if not on Friday. I just spent a nice relaxing hour stitching in the lounge, being all cosy, and watching one of my favourite floss tubes, which is the Fat Quarter Shop floss tube. And I was really shocked when Kimberly gave me and my floss tube a shout out, so that was a bit exciting. So yes, it's been a really nice day again today. I'm going to wrap the video up now because I need to get it all edited, and then I can go on, get on with cooking dinner and all that kind of stuff. But thank you ever so much for joining me again today, and I will see you all tomorrow.